"What has happened?" the Scarecrow asked a sad-looking man with a bushy beard, who wore an apron and was wheeling a baby carriage along the sidewalk.
"Why, we've had a revolution, Your Majesty, as you ought to know very well," replied the man. "And since you went away, the women have been running things to suit themselves. Oh, I'm glad you have decided to come back and restore order, for doing housework and minding the children is wearing out the strength of every man in the Emerald City."
Said the Scarecrow thoughtfully. "If it is such hard work as you say, how did the women manage it so easily?"
"Oh, I really do not know," replied the man with a deep sigh. "Perhaps the women are made of cast iron."
No movement was made as they passed along the street to oppose their progress. Several of the women stopped their gossip long enough to cast curious looks upon our friends, but immediately they would turn away with a laugh or a sneer and resume their chatter. And when they met with several girls belonging to the army of revolt, those soldiers, instead of being alarmed or appearing surprised, merely stepped out of the way and allowed them to advance without protest. This action rendered the Scarecrow uneasy.
"I'm afraid we are walking into a trap," said he.
"Nonsense," returned Nick Chopper confidently. "These silly creatures are conquered already."
But the Scarecrow shook his head in a way that expressed doubt, and Tip said,
"It's too easy altogether. Look out for trouble ahead."
"I will," returned His Majesty. Unopposed, they reached the royal palace and marched up the royal steps, which had once been thickly crusted with emeralds, but were now filled with tiny holes where the jewels had been ruthlessly torn from their settings by the army of revolt. And so far, not a rebel barred their way.